What is the name of this line segment?
Line of symmetry.
It is a line of symmetry. It does divide it in half. It's a very special line segment, though.
The diameter.
It's called the diameter.
Oh, man.
Diameter. So it goes all the way from one side to the other through the center of the circle. Very good. So looking at this line segment, we can imagine that we kind of take it and try to fit it onto the outside of this circle, right? And that's not going to be enough to make it all the way around. We have to use multiples of them. How many of those line segments do you think fits around the circle? What does it look like to you?
Does it go like one thing?
Well, like I said, it's a line segment, so it just stops here and there. Talking about what?
How much line
segments
can fit in a circle?
We'll say this diameter is 5 inches or something, right? If it was bendy or whatever, I could bend it over the circle. And it might go from, let's say we bent it around from here. It might make it to here, right? Like from there to there might be 5. Okay. So do you have a guess as to how many you think would make it around?
Two.
You think if I just put one more, it would make it all the way around the rest of the way? Maybe two? Four. 2.5? Somewhere around 3, you're thinking that seems reasonable. Okay. It turns out. Okay. Now I'm trying to convince you here at the beginning of the year that memorization is useful, but it is not a primary thing we should use to learn. Okay. To learn, we should understand things. And when we have the opportunity to understand over memorize, I'm going to go for understand. Okay. Really going to dive in and understand something. Rather than just memorize the area of a triangle's 1/2 base times height, we're going to draw little pictures, and then we don't actually have to draw those pictures anymore. We can imagine them in our brains. Say, if I take the triangle and I make another one, put it over there, put that over there, I make a rectangle, and it's half of that rectangle. So that makes sense why it's 1/2 base times height, right? We talked about that last time?
Yeah.
We can talk about it again. So, but in this case, it wouldn't be really reasonable to expect you to explain what I'm about to say to you. Okay? It is a bit of memorization, but at least it's going to make sense because we've all tried to guess at how many of those diameters can fit around the circle. And we're all saying around 3, and that's a pretty good guess. It's closer to
5, 9,
and it just keeps on going. What's that?
Pi.
And that's how many digits I know. You know more digits? Two after the 9?
I know more.
You know more?
Yeah. 3.14159927. I don't know anymore.
Okay, well, 2 more than me.
Okay,
so
what is pi
exactly? Pi. So pi is a really, it shows up in a lot of places, but it's, well, history is really, really old, right? So we're, sometimes we think we know, but we can't be 100% sure. We think that, I can't remember his name right now. Old Greek mathematician.
Robin Comedy.
Anyway, so a mathematician asked himself one time, let's say that, this question, how many of these diameters can fit around the the circumference.
That's a thing, yeah.
And through lots and lots of work of Hunter, all stop, please. Not supporting the class and our goal of learning. Okay. Asked himself this question, and then by, are we really having this much trouble? Can we stop doing this every time I turn around and I have to correct you again? Looking at each other and trying to make each other laugh. Please concentrate. Okay? By drawing shapes that have more and more and more and more sides to them and getting closer and closer and closer to a circle, they are able to arrive at this number pi. That number, one way to think of it is, how many diameters can fit around the circle? We can all see that it was around 3, as kind of believable. Just a little bit more than 3, 3.14. If we could carry this all the way out to the end, which we can't because it never ends, it would be how many diameters can fit around the circle. Okay? Or if we take the circle, the circumference, and we divide it by the diameter, right? That's pretty much the same question, right? I take the circumference, I divide it by the diameter, how many diameters are in the circumference?
You get pi.
Or if I take pi times the diameter, I get the circumference. Or, the way you've probably seen it more, in the diameter, there are two what's? This thing and this thing make the diameter, and they're called what?
A radius.
A radius. So, we could call the diameter just 2 times the radius, okay? And we get 2 pi r, right? 2 times the radius is the diameter, and there's our pi. So, there's maybe a familiar equation that you've seen before?
Yeah.
Seen that before? But now you can see more why that is, right? If we put the 2 and the r together, 2 times r is the diameter, and we just saw this truth intuitively. We said, well, that's 3.14. It looks pretty convincing. If I take the diameter and I try to stretch it, you know, multiple times around the circle, it would take about 3 of them. It would take actually pi of them, 3.14159 27, and so on and so on. Okay? All right. So that's where the name number came from. The dedicated mathematicians examining what would be the circumference of a circle that's not really a circle, it's a bunch of straight lines, right? And then making more, like, making those shapes have more and more and more sides, like hundreds of sides.
So does pi like never end?
Never ends. I mean, it is a finite number. If this is 0 and this is 4. Okay, 1, 2, 3, then pi is right about there, okay? It is exactly in one place on the number line. It's just that we could never, if we write it as a decimal, we'll never get the last decimal place, okay? There's lots of numbers like that. Okay, so that's our first little mission here, is gonna come up with this, but not have it be completely magic and out of the blue. Yeah.
So just a general question.
Yeah.
I just thought about this. If they have like math equations named pi, do they have one named like cupcake or something like that? And I'm just asking.
Do you not really know the answer to that?
Well, I would say yes and no, but I don't know because they named an equation after pi.
Okay, so that pi is not cherry pie. Right.
Well, I knew that, but like.
So it's a Greek letter. Pi. Okay. So you got your Greek alphabet. You know, not an expert on Greek alphabet. You got alpha,
beta,
gamma,
delta,
epsilon,
zeta, epsilon, zeta, eta, theta, alpha, kappa, lambda, mu.
We learned this, but I forgot it.
Yeah,
so somewhere in there,
good job, you guys.
Somewhere in that alphabet is a letter called pi. Okay, a letter called pi. So we chose that letter because a lot of old mathematicians were Greek, and they said let's use Greek letters. Okay, I believe pi, because pi starts with P, and so does perimeter. I think that's where it comes from.
Okay.
So no, there's not cupcake because there's no Greek letter called cupcake. But there are other letters, like there's a phi. There's a number assigned to phi. It's another coming to me right now. But we use Greek letters a lot in math notation because it has a lot of Greek roots.
Okay,
so 2 pi r. Circumference is 2 pi r, but hopefully not too much magic left in that. We can see it's just about 3 diameters make up the circumference. That's one way that we can remind ourselves that circumference equals 2 pi r. Now about this question. These binders. How would you stack them? So like you could theoretically just stack them forever and ever straight up so they never fall over. Cool?
You could like put them one like that, like so that the fat is facing the side. Then put the other one so it's like the other side.
The other way?
Yeah.
Okay. And when we stack 2 of them, then they're like flat again, and we start all over.
That's
fine,
yeah.
32. That's a pretty common way to stack binders. You've probably seen binders stacked that way, right? So if you're going to stack them high, we alternate them like that. Okay? Now, we're going to do something a little bit later where these two things come together. That's what they can do with each other, okay? But what we have to do first is talk about the shape that we were on last time. Remember what shape we were on?
Trapezoid.
Trapezoid. Okay. So let's talk about that there, trapezoid. Actually, I'm going to draw a trapezoid with my shape tool. It'll be amazing. What makes a trapezoid? Well, you can just stop at that first sentence or statement. Two sides are parallel. Done. Then you don't have to make the other sides anything. They could be parallel. Then we just have like a special kind of a trapezoid, which is a parallelogram. And if they have 90 degrees, this is a special kind. It's called a rectangle, right? Remember talking about shapes like that? How some squares are rectangles, but not all rectangles are squares, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
So just one set of parallel sides, that's all that you need. As long as you have that, you have a trapezoid. Let's see if I give you this side being, let's call it 12, we'll call this one 7, we'll call this 8. If this from here all the way to here, not to here, but all the way to here is 12, that's 7, that's 8. You may know and you may not know, and it's fine. Let's see if you can make your best guess what the area of that trapezoid is. And then, of course, we'll talk about it, and we'll figure out how we would find the exact area. Okay. All right, let's just throw it out there.
50%.
You got 103.
96. We're talking about area here, right? So first let's talk about 103. What?
Squared.
103 squared?
Yeah.
Squares.
Yeah.
Is it squared or squares?
Squared.
Next bonus.
Because it's not 3D, so it's squared.
Squares.
Squared.
Squared.
Inches.
Squares.
So
this is the debate.
Oh my gosh.
Is it squares?
Is it
squares?
Squares.
Or is it
squares? Squares. Squares. How is it squares?
Okay, let's settle this. Let's look at an easier shape
squares.
And settle this.
It's 103
squared.
What, just before we do anything here, what is area?
Squares that can fit.
Squares that can fit. How many squares can fit?
100 squares.
Talked about how we could use hexagons or circles, which is a terrible idea, or rectangles, but we settled on squares. How many squares can fit? Okay. If this is a rectangle, which is like the most ideal shape for finding areas, right? Because it's easy to calculate how many squares can fit in there. If it's 5 squares can fit this way, and 3 squares can fit this way, then how many squares can fit in the whole thing?
15.
Now here's the question. Squared?
Squares. squares fit in there?
15 squares.
That's how many squares you put inside the perimeter.
15 squares.
15 squares.
Is 15 squares.
Hold on, hold on.
Wait,
Sid?
Square. That's what
squares.
I mean.
Okay,
this is
square.
Square.
We just
square.
Right.
It's
look.
Not square.
Let's run through this. What is area? What's area? How many squares can fit?
15.
15
squares can fit.
Oh my god.
15
there
squares.
You go, Schmidt.
Squares.
15.
Now look.
Shapes.
15 squared.
It's 30.
What does squared mean?
Multiply.
15 times 15.
15, which is
200. I mean, this two up here means something. 15 times 15 is 225.
That's
now
not
we have a new number.
225.
You cannot fit 225
squares in that tiny.
Well, maybe super tiny squares.
Right, but these squares, I can fit 5 of them this way and 3 of them this way. If I can fit 5 this way and 3 this way, can I fit 225 of these squares?
No.
How many squares can I fit?
15 squares.
So.
Yes.
15 squares.
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 Not squared, squares.
Let's clear up this squared squares confusion right now. The reason why some of you want to put squared is because I've left something out that you're like not realizing I've left out. I've left out.
Inches.
I've what?
Units.
Inches, centimeters, whatever.
Millimeters.
Millimeters. Let's call it millimeters.
Millimeters.
Now, 15 squares still, right? What kind of squares?
Millimeter
squares.
Millimeter squares.
Yes.
And that's all it means.
Yeah,
15 millimeters.
15 millimeter squares. 15 squares that are millimeters on every side.
Okay.
1 millimeter on every side. Okay.
Good.
So when we're thinking squared, what we're remembering is this squared, which is really just telling me what kind of squares. How many squares? 15. What kind of squares? Millimeter squares. All right.
So which one?
Yes.
It's squares.
15 squares. You want to get more specific if I tell you the actual name of the unit? 15 millimeter squares.
No.
15 squared was not right, because 15 squared is 15 times 15 is 225.
Oh,
okay. All right, so I think we've cleared this up. 103, what?
Squares.
We don't even know if it's right. If 103 squares can fit in there. Marcus?
I got 48.
You got 48 squares.
I got.
Yeah?
96.
96 squares.
I got that.
Yes?
96.
96 as well.
56
squares. Alright, let's look at this. What's the most answers here that could be right? The most. How many of these answers could possibly be right?
One
answer could be right.
All
of them wrong.
All of them could be right. Zero could be right. Zero could be right. At most one could be right. Not all of these can be right. Which one's right? How can we ever know? How will we ever
know?
You.
Tell us the answer.
We're going to work on it together, of course. Like moving stuff, you're gonna convince us of your answer?
Yeah.
Yes.
Not just say, I multiplied these two numbers and then I did this with those numbers and then I got this answer?
I'm pretty sure that's what I'm gonna say.
And you can say, I multiplied these numbers and here's why I multiplied these numbers, that's what I wanna hear.
Okay.
I might be able to do that.
Can I do that?
Yes, I can do that.
Alright, we'll give you a try first.
Alright, I don't think I need to pen.
Brandon.
12 times 8.
Why?
Because base times height.
Why?
Because
12
times 8 is 96.
That's how many squares that fit there. That's right down there.
Yeah. Alright, keep going.
And then I added
plus 7.
Added 7, which is 103.
Shut up, Cole.
It's on the top.
Squares.
Okay, what I want you to explain to me is.
Good. 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 Good
Okay, I see. Is it sit down? I'm about to explain. Think, are we supporting each other as we try to?
Yes,
learn?
That's right.
Yeah.
I don't know.
This seems like magic. Why?
You're not.
I have no clue.
Why 12 times 8 and then plus 7?
Why do you have to divide by 2 though?
Why?
It's a triangle.
I'm lost. I mean, we should restart an idea.
Let's look at this real quick. Let me just disprove you real quick. Okay? Just start to disprove you and show you that this is too big. And I don't know what this means exactly.
Plus seven.
Well, think about this. 12 times 8 is going to be some squares, right?
Yeah.
But this 7, when I measure this as 7, really measuring squares. I'm measuring like sides of squares. These aren't squares. If these are inches, then these are inch squares. These are inches. We can't add inch squares to inches. So those things aren't even the same kind of thing, so we can't add them together. Let me show you this too. 12 times 8. Let me show you a shape that has an area of 12 times 8. This rectangle.
96.
This rectangle right here. That rectangle is 12 on the base. 8 is the height. The area of that is 12 times 8. What is that?
96.
96. Okay. Is the area of that rectangle bigger or smaller than the area of the trapezoid?
Bigger.
Bigger.
It's more area. It's too big. Not only is it too big already, then you add 7.
Yeah.
It's even more too big.
That's my fault.
So, I've just, by drawing, see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm explaining to you why that can't work. Can we explain what would work and why? That's what I want to hear. I want to hear what works and why it works. Okay. I had to re-explain this to myself countless times because I do not run into trapezoids all that often. Okay. But then when I do need to know the area of a trapezoid, which is pretty common in like calculus, we use trapezoids in calculus when we're looking for areas under curves. And I pretty much forget what it is every year, and I have to re-tell myself what the formula is. Not look it up. I don't have to look it up. I just look at the trapezoid and say, oh, I know these two sides are parallel, so let me just move this stuff around and, oh, right, I see why that's the formula. Okay? So, anybody can explain what numbers to multiply together, but not only that, why would you do that? Divide by 2, why would you do that? Multiply 12 by 8, why? Anybody want to take a crack at it? Marcus? Seems like you had something?
I don't think it's right.
Do you have something like that though? Like what
I did, drawing a rectangle?
That's fine?
I don't think
it's as long as it's something like that, an explanation of why what you did must be true. It might be wrong, but it's okay.
I'll pass.
You're gonna pass?
Yeah.
Okay. Here's an idea. Down here.
Small.
All right, so here is a trapezoid that I want to know the area of. Okay. We've used all this cutting and moving and copying and that kind of stuff, like with a triangle. Do you remember what we did with the triangle? Real quick, we had a triangle we want to know the area of. We just imagined that we'd make a copy of it. We could flip it over and put it right there.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, but now we have two triangles, right? So we have too much area, but we have a nice, like, it's twice as much. So whatever area of the two triangles, we just cut it in half. And I can just cut this off, move it over here, it'll fit in perfectly. Now I have a rectangle that is the same base as the original triangle, the same height as the original triangle, but that rectangle has an area of base times height, but is that the area of the triangle? No, because how many triangles have I put up here?
Three.
Two.
Oh, two.
How many have the original? Two, yeah, I made a copy. Here's the original, I made a copy, so all the shapes together have twice as much area as I need, okay? I cut this little piece off, I just slid it over there, still has the same area. When I find the area of base times height, I need to take how much of that?
You have to take
side by two, because this is the area of two triangles. I only have the area of one triangle. Okay, so there's our 1/2 base times height. We've heard that before.
Yeah.
1/2 base times height. But this little drawing and other drawings like it explain why it's 1/2 base times height. Right? I'm gonna do a similar thing with this trapezoid.
So then so the trapezoid will turn over and then you'll put it on the trapezoid.
Same as that?
Yeah.
So I'll just copy it, flip that copy over, slide that in there. Try to line it up nice.
It's a rectangle.
Is it a rectangle?
No.
And then you cut
from the
parallel. You need to do what we did yesterday.
Then
trapezoid. So
cut that off.
Put that on the left side.
Put that over there.
And then we can
go
8. So you're saying 12 times 8?
That's what the base is.
Let's see, this is 12 from here to there.
Wait, on the one you want 24 times 16, I think.
24 times 16, why?
You're adding two shapes.
There are two shapes, but this part right here, how long is this?
12.
If I reference back to the
12.
Original, 12, how long is this?
7.
Ah, okay. So how long is this whole thing?
19. 19.
It's just 19. And how tall is it?
8.
8.
So then 19 times 8.
19 times 8, that's it?
And then you divide by 2.
Divide by 2 because
there's
two of them, so we don't have that. Sound good, everybody?
Yeah.
Okay, so now all we need for formula is to not use specific numbers, but use like just general, if this is this long, this is that long. Here's what I would do with all those numbers, right? So instead of 12, we can call it B1. So this is B1. Okay? It's like, you can think of it as like the long base. Okay. Instead of calling it specifically 7, we'll just give it a name of B2. So this would also be B2. But the height's the same. So the height is the height. So what we did, what Hunter did, is take the trapezoid, copy it, flip it over, fit it together. You can see, at least your intuition can tell you that would lay perfectly along here. This would make a straight line like that. Okay? Anyway, cut this little piece off, put it over there. What we've made is a what shape?
A rectangle.
A rectangle. A rectangle is easy to find the area of base times height, right? We can fit however many this is, plus however many this is. That's how many squares I can fit along there. I can fit however many this way, okay? In the example we have, we can fit 12 and 7. That's a total of 19 squares this way. We can fit 8 this way. But that's twice as much as we need. We have two shapes making up this rectangle, two identical shapes. So half of that, that's the area that we need. Okay? So in this case, it's half. Okay? Let's try it again. I'm going to give you another one. See if you can remember what Hunter said. Maybe you'll have to recreate this in your mind. Okay? But see if you can come up with it. I'm going to put on a new page. I'll give you some numbers. 21, 13, and 9. Okay, if I put this now right here, maybe can I rotate it just right? All right. Now, this guy here is down here. This guy is up there. It's a perfect copy, right? It's a parallelogram right now. But if I move this, or that way, if I move this over to here,
can I have
okay. Then we make a what shape?
Rectangle.
Now it's a rectangle.
90,
90, 90. Can I find the area of this rectangle?
How can
you? Yeah.
21 plus 13.
That's how long this side is.
34.
34.
Times height, 9.
21 plus 13. That's how I came up with this. And then we did what with it?
Times the height, which is 9.
Times 9.
We get 306.
306. 306. Is that it?
No.
No.
And then divide it by two.
Why would we divide by two?
Because of the triangle that we chose.
The triangle?
Or the, you know, the other.
It's two identical shapes. Right? I found the area of two of them. I only want the area of one of them, so this is the area of two. I'll just cut that in half. Gives me an area of one of them.
153.
153?
Yep.
153 what? Squares.
Oh, squares.
All right, some real simple homework, and that will be for a trapezoid. Okay, I'm going to draw this on your paper that has not specific numbers, right? Base 1, base 2, height h. All I want you to do is come to class next time with a formula for the area of the trapezoid based on this little thing here. No, let's do a fresh piece, okay? And now we got a few seconds left. Yes, Sid?
So you want us to come up with our own formula?
Yeah, I want you to, like, we can do it specifically. And I bet if I gave you a bunch of examples, you could just do it over and over and over and over. Show me, like, the steps for finding the area of the trapezoid. And all I have to do is replace this with the number that belongs to this side, this with the number that belongs to this side, and the height. Okay. I want your formula to involve base 1, base 2, and height. Have a good day. Have a good lunch. Goodbye.
Thank you.